5 on your health tonight. New concerns about a seasonal virus that can, in rare cases, cause polio-like symptoms in children. Here to explain is Dr. Kristin Moffitt, an infectious disease specialist at Boston Children's Hospital. Thanks for joining us, Dr. Moffitt.
Hey, Dr. Moffitt. Off the top, that sounds scary. So it's polio-like, but it's not polio, right?
Correct. So okay. The symptoms look like polio, but it's not caused by the polio virus.
So it, what is it called? It's called EV-D68?
That's right.
How does it spread?
EV-D68 stands for enterovirus D68. And this is a virus that is a member of a family of some of the most common viruses to cause respiratory infection in children. So it spread via the respiratory route. So that's through coughing or sneezing or saliva or secretions. And most children or teenagers who get this will just experience a mild respiratory infection, maybe with a fever. But in rare circumstances, and on very rare cases, it can cause these more severe polio-like symptoms.
Mm-hmm. All right, and when should parents call you? What are we looking for?
Yeah, so again, I just want to say that the development of these polio-like symptoms is very rare, but could be very serious. So the symptoms to be on the lookout for would be either leg or arm weakness, maybe a change in a child's gait, potentially a difficulty swallowing or slurring of their speech, or maybe drooping of their eyelids or other facial droop. Any of those symptoms would warrant an evaluation with a physician right away.
Those are signals that a parent or an adult would see immediately. So we talked a lot about this next question I'm going to ask you with COVID. The MWRA, the Massachusetts Water Resources Authority, now tracks EV-D68 levels in local wastewater. So yeah. Let's take a look at this right here. As you can see, the red line is the Boston area. The green line is Worcester County. The levels at both testing sites have been rising steadily since mid-August. Yep. What could that mean for you and your colleagues at Children's?
Yeah, so first I'll just say that having data like these available for viruses other than SARS-CoV-2 is really, really a leap forward and incredibly helpful. We know for SARS-CoV-2, and we've had data like these for years, that rising levels in the wastewater have been one of the earliest indicators that COVID-19 cases in the community were about to rise. So these rising levels for EV-D68 are not surprising. Mm-hmm. It's late summer and fall when we expect to see enteroviruses like this one increasing in transmission. But again, the more cases of EV-D68 there are, even if this development of polio-like symptoms is a really rare outcome of that infection, if there are just more cases of the infection that might cause it, we really need to be on the lookout for those symptoms.
And that could be a good tip as to what you know it might be coming or whatever surge. So it's very good information. Thank
All
you,
right.
Doctor.
Great information. Thank Dr. Moffitt, and we will talk to you soon.